Hey y'all, I'm Leah, and today I'm going to show you how to create your very first Python package. By turning your code into a Python package, you can do a few things. One, you can use it in different environments. So this means that you don't have to copy and paste functions into different parts of your workflows on your computer. The second thing that it allows you to do is put your code on a platform like GitHub and then install it from there. You can also use this package structure to publish to PyPI, the Python Package Index. There are a couple of things that you need to know about to create a Python package. The first is that you need a very specific directory structure, so we're going to create that together. You also are going to need a pyproject.toml file, which stores all the metadata for your package. And then finally, you're going to want an init.py file. Okay, so let's get started. So you can see here, I have a terminal open within VS Code. My file directory structure is over here to the left. And when we get to doing some work with various files and code, we'll be working in this window up here. So I'm just gonna start by making sure that I have Hatch already installed. So I can just type Hatch version and I can see that I have Hatch already installed. I'm gonna go ahead and just clear this out. So after that, I mentioned that some of the key elements of creating a Python package are this file directory structure, an init file, and a pyproject.toml file. And lucky for us, Hatch will create all of these things for us. So I'm going to use Hatch, new, and then I'm going to call the package pyOS package. And when I hit return, notice that Hatch returns this directory structure, and you can see that in my file explorer over here in VS Code as well. A few things to notice about this structure. First, it has the high-level package directory. It's called pyOS package. This is just your project directory. It then has a source directory. This is where your source code is going to live. And then within the source directory, we have a pyOS package directory. This is where your actual code is going to live. This is where your package lives. And we know that because there's this init.py file. So that file just tells Python, it says, hey Python, within this directory, there is some code that we are going to want to import into a Python environment and use. And the about file, we can just remove that file. Now, a few other things to notice. There's a license file. This is a very important legal definition of how people can use and reuse or share your code. And then the README file we'll talk about in a different video. The pyproject.toml file is where all of your metadata are stored. Now, we're ready to add some code. So let's go ahead and add a file. We're going to add this file within the source pyOS package directory. So what I'm going to start doing here is I'm just going to cd or change directory into the pyOS package directory. And then once I'm in that directory, I'm going to create a new file, but I'm going to do this at the command line. So I'm going to do touch to create a new file. I want the file to live in my source directory within the pyOS package folder or directory. And I'm going to call it add numbers.py. So I'm going to add that file. And what you should notice when we do that is that file gets added to our file structure. So we've got the first part of our package created. The structure is created. We have a license. We have a metadata file. And now we have our first Python module. A module, by the way, is just a fancy name for a .py file, a Python file. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to add some code to our module that we just created. So I'm going to minimize my terminal here so it's not taking up so much space. And I'm going to open this addNumbers.py file. Now, if we wanted to open it from the terminal, we could use the command code, and then we could just go to the source directory, pyOS package, and find that addNumbers.py file and hit enter. You could also just double click in the file explorer. Now, the first thing that you're going to want to do now that we're in this editor is we're going to add a module docstring at the top of our file. So a docstring is just some information or metadata about your code. And in this case, for this module, we want to tell people that are looking at it what it does. So I'm just going to write, this is a module that adds two numbers together. So this is really high-tech Python coding that we're doing here. We're going to be adding some numbers together. This docstring is just helpful to add to make your code more user-friendly, more contributor-friendly. And now I'm going to create a function using def, and I'm going to create a function called addNumbers. And that function is going to take two input variables, A and B, and it is going to return the sum of A and B. So I'm going to go ahead and add another thing to this, which is typing. And typing is just a way to tell Python, hey, Python, A should always be a number, or in this case, an integer, and B also will be an integer, and this function is going to return an integer. Now for this function, we also want to add a docstring, and I have this really nice plugin or extension for VS Code that will create a NumPy style docstring. There are lots of different docstring styles, but we're going to use NumPy. We recommend that at pyOpenSci as a standard for Python documentation. And at the top, we're just going to add a description, a short one-line statement about what this does. This is a function that adds two integers together and returns the sum of those integers. And then we want to describe the parameters. So they're both integers, and then we can describe what they are. And then again, it's going to return an integer. And so the return value is the sum of inputs A and B. So that's our docstring. This is going to be really helpful for users if they want to understand how a function should work and what the inputs should be. And so now let's just create the function. So essentially this function is going to just return the sum of A plus B. And so I'm going to save that. And you might notice that my code is being formatted as I save. I've got an auto formatter turned on in VS Code, which is really nice. And so here we go. So now we have a Python module called addNumbers.py. Within that module, we have one function called addNum that adds two numbers together and returns an integer. And we also have this nice directory structure that Hatch created for us that has the pyOS directory that contains our addNumbers.py module. And we know that this will be an importable module because we've added this init.py file that, remember, that's what tells Python, hey, this is something that we're going to want to import and use in our code. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to look at this pyproject.toml file. So here's our pyproject.toml file. And what I want you to notice here at the top of the file, you have the build system. So this is really what's telling Python the tool that it needs to use to build your package. And specifically, this is what pip is going to use when you also install your package. It's going to build it and then install it. So we're using Hatchling, which is the build backend that comes with Hatch. And there's some more information in the project description below if you're curious what a build backend is. We don't need to touch this section. Let's look at the project section. So the first thing we're going to do here is, notice it says dynamic version. We're going to go ahead and just make the version an explicit value. So we're going to set the version to be 0.1. And we are also going to add a description. So this is a Python package that adds numbers together. If you're curious about dynamic versioning, we'll cover that in another video. The next thing I'm going to look at is this requires Python field. And we want to make this the minimum version of Python that our package will support. And so I'm going to change this to 3.10. You can change this to whatever version makes sense for the code that you are writing. Everything else here, the keywords, the authors, I'm not going to worry about for right now. So you can just leave things as they are because we are just focused on installing our code. And then finally, the classifiers. Now, this is specific to if you want to publish to PyPy, you will need these. If you're not publishing to PyPy, you could delete this entire section. What I'm going to do is delete just the parts I don't need because in another video, we will be publishing to PyPy. And so we'll have these classifiers there. So I'm going to delete Python 3.8 and 3.9 because remember, above here, we defined that the minimum version of Python is going to be 3.10. And we also are going to delete these two lines because this is a pure Python package. There's no other languages involved with developing this package. So I'm going to delete those and we have no dependencies. So there's no other Python packages needed to run our add numbers module. And finally, the rest of this stuff, I'm going to go ahead and delete this version element. This is also a dynamic versioning piece. And we're just going to now save this pyproject.toml file as it is. So now you are ready to install your package. Let's just go over what we just went through. So we used hatch to create this directory structure. And then we added to this directory structure a module called addNumbers.py that has a single function with a docstring that just adds two numbers together and returns that value. And we also have a license file, a pyproject.toml file, and a README file. And we made some modifications to the pyproject.toml file to ensure that the versions of Python that we support are in line with our code. And then also we made sure that the actual package version was static. So we just defined it as being 0.1. So now we can go ahead and install the package. I'm going to clear out my terminal here. I'm going to move this up just a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. And the first thing that I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a fresh new Python environment. And I'm going to use Mamba to do that. So I'm going to type Mamba create. I want to name my environment. I'm just going to call it PyOS package. And I want the Python version to be version 3.10, and I'm going to hit enter. Now, if you're using a different environment manager, go ahead and use VENV or virtual environment or whatever environment manager you prefer. I'm just using Conda because that is what I have installed on this computer. So now I'm going to go ahead and do Mamba activate pyOS package to activate the environment. Okay, so now that we've created this environment and we've entered the environment, I can run conda list and get a list of packages that are installed into this environment. Now, if you were using VENV or some other environment manager where you're working with pip, you would just use pip list instead of conda list. So the last step of our process here is to install your package. And to install the package, you need to make sure that you are in the pyOS package directory. The last thing that we're going to do is do a pip install -e and a period prompt to install the package within the directory that we're in. So that would be the pyOS package. So I'm going to hit return and it's going to go ahead and build my package. It's going to install it in editable mode. What that means is that I can make updates to the package. I can restart my Python kernel and I can test those updates in real time. This is a great way if you're developing a tool to allow for dynamic updates so that you can test them locally as you're working. And now let's run conda list again. And you can see that pyOS package is now installed in our environment. So let's go ahead and open a Python prompt. So I'm just going to type Python. I'm going to open up a Python prompt. Notice that I have Python 3.10. I'm going to import from pyOS package, import add numbers. Remember, add numbers is the name of our module that we can import into Python. So I'm going to import it, and then I'm going to call add numbers, and I'm going to look for the function. So by tab completing, Python will discover that function. I'm going to give it two numeric values that are integers, and I'm going to hit return, and we can see that the output is 3, as we would expect. So we have now together created a Python package, the simplest version of a Python package. We added a module within it. Remember, modules are just PY files that contain code and functions that we want to import into a Python environment. Because we made this file structure that creates a Python package, we can import that code into any Python environment that we want. And if we did go ahead and put this code on GitHub, we could also install it from GitHub.